We have a poll going on. Go to earwolf.com/blog. There's a poll. Should I retire What's Up Hot Dog for good or bring it back for at least one show? You can vote for yourself. Voting is still open.
I got a poll going on.
Would you shut up? Let me introduce him to you. He is a writer for Parks and Recreation, which is a show on NBC with Amy Poehler. He was a writer for the Sarah Silverman program, which was a TV show on Comedy Central. He is also a stand-up comedian. He does other things, but he is most known for a little section of the show that we like to call Harris's Phone Corner. Let me introduce to you comedian Harris Wittels. Welcome, Harris.
Thanks for having me back, Scott.
You're clapping for yourself. That is.
Oh,
really...
come on. Don't throw me under the clap bus. That was not me. That was not me.
Harris, welcome to the show. It's great to see you. Let me explain a little bit of what happened. Now, you've been on the show a few times, and you have something you call Harris's Phone Corner. Explain what this is.
I just like to record any thoughts or jokes or sniglets into my phone and the notes.
Are you allowed to call them sniglets?
I can do whatever the fuck I want.
It's your phone.
It's my phone. It's my podcast.
Wait a minute.
So, yeah, and I just come here and I read them, and then you guys just shit on me. And it's
a very popular segment.
Sadism.
And what happened last time was you were here maybe a month ago or so, and you were going to be doing what you're going to be doing today, which is Harris's Phone Corner for the entire hour.
Yeah.
We're just going to go through. We're going to breeze through them. You're going to open up your phone and just run through joke by joke.
Yeah.
We should get about 60 or maybe 50, 50 to 60.
Somewhere in that range. Yeah, sounds good. But I got robbed last time.
You got robbed last time because the person who does our theme song, Reggie Watts, decided to stick around, mm-hmm. and it just totally usurped your entire episode.
Yeah.
So that is not going to happen today. We are going to get to Harris's Phone Corner. But before we do, I do want to just go through your career a little bit to cement you in the mind of the new listener.
Okay.
You are a comedian who's also a writer and a performer?
Yeah, as you've said like three times already in the first 2 minutes of the episode. I am. I am those things. Yeah, what do you want to know?
Well, what is your life like? How do you wake up in the morning?
Well, during the hiatus from Parks that I've been on?
No, just any day.
I'd say I wake up with a hearty yawn. And,
wait, do you mean a hard-on?
Yeah, I wake up with Ed Hardy on.
Ed Hardy pajamas?
Yeah. Footy.
Ed Hardy footy pajamas.
And so I wake up with a big boner in my Ed Hardy footies.
All right, well, that's great to...
And then I roll over and go back to sleep.
Hello.
Yeah. But that's about it.
And what have you been working on lately? You obviously Parks and Rec is coming back. It just came back on Thursday.
Yeah.
But you are done with it now?
Well, we wrote and shot all the episodes in advance, so I'm off for like 6 months.
So wait a minute. How is Leslie Knope going to address
if, who? Just kidding.
If, say, something happens in the news, like 9/11, another 9/11 happens.
Right. We predicted everything pretty much. So, I mean, so far pretty accurate.
Okay. Yeah, the first episode was wildly accurate, I have to say. Prescient.
Right. Yeah. We shot it like 7 months ago. It was all about the Arizona shooting.
So Leslie gets involved on a street level?
Yeah, so we've been pretty lucky, I guess. I mean, not lucky, because who wants that to have happened?
Yeah, who wants that kind of luck?
But in terms of ratings and timeliness, perfect for us.
So you've shot all of them, and now you're not working?
Right.
You're on hiatus.
I'm on hiatus, yeah.
Okay, and what are you doing during your hiatus?
I've been doing exactly three things.
Mm-hmm.
The first is I started a gym called...
A gymnasium?
A gymnasium. It's Bally Partial Fitness.
Okay.
So that's one thing.
Wait, you're not going to go into that at all? You're just going to leave that hanging?
Well, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's for people
who don't...
I'd
love to hear a little bit about it.
If you don't want to get too jacked...
Mm-hmm. Who does?
Yeah. Then, you know, go to Bally Partial Fitness. It's just a ball. It's a big room.
A medicine ball?
A medicine ball, yeah.
Wow.
And
people
to...
take turns throwing it around?
Yeah. Well, yeah, they can't all throw it at once. Well, I guess they could.
That'd be kind of interesting.
That'd be partial
fitness.
What
if everyone got their hands on yeah, the ball just... at the same time, picked it up, and then all heaved it?
Yeah, that would
I
be...
I wonder if 12 people mm-hmm. were all throwing a ball, could they throw it farther than one person throwing that same ball?
Yeah.
Hmm.
You wouldn't think it, but yeah. It's
they 12 times as far?
Yeah, absolutely. Wow. It's precisely 12. It's pretty crazy.
Then why don't people who play football... Mm-hmm. Why don't you have 12 quarterbacks? Then it seems like you could do long bombs every single...
Right. Well, I don't know. I'm not much of a sports guy, but
why'd
I
why'd you open a gym?
I'm not in a... You don't have to, like, be in a sports to want to look...
To want to make money.
Of, kind of tone.
Oh, so you're, like, you were the first client.
I'm the only client.
Where are these other 11 people throwing the balls?
Scott, I bought a medicine ball that's in my garage.
Okay.
That's basically what it is.
That's what we're getting down to.
So that's the first thing.
And a very expensive computer system with a card swiping ID recognition.
Right. So that was a waste.
All right. Well, what's the second thing you're up to on your hiatus?
I've been doing
Second of three.
The ad campaigns for Romeo and Juliet. Just making sure there's enough jokes on the billboards.
Okay, good.
So far, I think we squeezed...
Half of a joke per billboard?
Well, no, like three or four in one sentence. It's pretty...
Really?
Well, just
Which
the
one?
Title alone... Nomeo.
Okay, so you count that as one?
That's one. The other...
Can you really take credit for that?
Yeah, I did it.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. And then the tagline is a little adventure goes a lawn way.
Mm-hmm.
So you have little adventure, like gnomes are little, sure. And then you have a lawn, like a lawn gnome.
Sure, a long way.
So that's three, just alone.
A little adventure goes a long way.
Lawn.
What's this?
Lawn.
A long way, yes.
Lawn. L-A-W.
Long way.
No.
L-O-N-G?
Well, it's a play on that, sure. But it's actually lawn.
What are you saying?
Lawn,
a long way.
Adventure goes a long way. So...
Olivia Venture.
Olivia Venture. What do you think it is?
Olivia Venture goes a long way. It's all about a girl named Olivia Venture.
Well, actually, that's what it was
takes
originally.
A journey through the Ozarks.
Right. Well, that's... But I thought that was too on the nose, because that's what the story is, basically.
Okay.
I was like, let's have fun with it.
All right. So you did that. So that's two jokes.
Two things that I'm doing, not jokes.
No, but two jokes on the poster.
Oh, okay. That... No, well, the third is the name of the movie.
No, you got the name of the movie, and then you got a little
adventure.
Goes along... Oh, wait. So you're cutting the one sentence into two different separate jokes?
I crammed two jokes into that one sentence. A little adventure.
That's one?
Little
you
gnome,
count that
that's
as one?
That's one joke.
Boy.
Lawn way.
All right.
Second joke in that sentence.
All right. Well, congratulations on that. All right. So the third thing you have going of three.
Started a four non-blondes cover band. It's
mm-hmm.
called One Non-Blonde. That's me and my guitar. And we do What's
now
Up.
Now, you're not counting your guitar as a non-blonde?
Well, it's
or
blonde.
Your guitar is blonde.
It is.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
And I also have a beer on stage, but that's a blonde, too.
Okay.
So I can't count that either.
Sure.
And I have a golden lap.
This is tough. You just seem to surround yourself with blondes.
It should be called One Non-Blonde and Three Blondes, but that's bulky. And if we've learned anything from my ad campaigns for Romeo and Juliet, succinct.
Uh-huh.
So I've been doing that.
What kind of songs do you play?
Well, just the one.
Hmm.
25 years and my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope. Oh, destination. So I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high and I scream from the top of my lungs, what's going on? Are we clipping? Doug, are we clipping?
What does your guitar do while you do that?
It's actually, I have to put strings in that.
Yeah.
But
you gotta get some sort of reminder.
Yeah. I write it on.
You could tie a string around your finger, maybe, and then take that string off and put it on your guitar.
Can I tell a true story? I know we're having fun.
Okay.
I was playing a show with my band in high school.
Okay. Which band is this?
This was, they were called Pralines and Dick. It was a jam band, and it was a, I assume this is true, but it was a play on that Wayne's World joke.
Uh-huh.
Not a play on it, it just was it. And
I love to hear your plays and your takes on humor. I stole a joke.
Our idea was that we'd get legions of fans, and they'd be called dickheads, which cracked us up to no end. Yeah, but our guitarist was playing, and the string broke and went through his finger. The metal string just went through the front of his forehead. It was crazy. And he kept playing, and then after the song, he's like, the string's in my hand.
Oh, my Lord.
Like, oh, my God. But, great
story.
Out. I don't know. He died.
Oh, really?
Heroin overdose.
Not the drug. Like heroin's. Fiction. He read too many books.
Too many books and forgot to feed himself.
Emily Bronte.
Yeah.
All right. Good stuff.
Thanks.
So that's the third of three?
That's everything that they've been doing for real.
Okay, so we can move on now to Harris's Phone Corner?
Sure. Foam Corner or Phone Corner?
Now, we talked about this last time. You do have Harris's Foam Corner, which is a big party that you have in a room where you spray foam on everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone stands in their respective corners. It's almost like the skating game where everyone gets in a corner and they throw the dice, the big, you know, tumbly felt dice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, everyone has to get in a corner. So really only four people can attend.
But this is not that. This is the phone corner.
Okay. Yes.
And we're going to do this for a long time, practically the entire hour.
A long time?
What's this?
What did you say?
Wait, what is that? What is that? Oh,
I think that's a big truck.
That's the big rig.
Wait. Truck. Okay. Great. All right, truck is gone, and we're going to do Harris's Phone Corner for the entire hour and hit us. We'll tell you what, Bobby, why don't we do a little feature on the show? Do you want to stick around for this?
Okay, very cool.
All right, this is a little feature that we call Jukebox Jury. Let's do it.
Actually, I'm going to leave if Fabrice is going to call.
Okay, sure. Whatever you like.
I was outside.
Oh, this total asshole came in here and
yeah, we almost got in a fight.
Yeah, it was bizarre.
What did he say?
You are a breath of fresh air. I have to say,
you're such a pleasant personality compared to that guy.
Oh, thank you.
You're catty, but you're not an asshole.
No,
but you're catty.
Thank you.
Yeah, you are a little
That's
catty.
Nice. You're doggy.
I'd work on that if I were you.
I'm doggy.
All right, this is one of our least popular segments on the show. It's called Jukebox Jury. It's probably the worst segment we've ever done, but Harris requested to do it, so we're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And this is basically, I don't think we've done this in about 3 weeks, 4 weeks, something like that.
It's but, fun that we give people their big break.
Yeah. So, you know, we play a lot of comedy music on the show, and a lot of times people write in and say, how can you play my song? I'm funny. And so what you do is you go to our Facebook page, Comedy Death Ray Radio's Facebook page, and you post your song under the appropriate discussion thread in the forum, and you can get played on Jukebox Jury here. And what will happen is we'll play the song until we can stand it no longer. And at that point, much like the Gong Show, someone will say, stop the music, and then we'll discuss it and usually shit on it. Unless it's great, and if it's great, we'll let it play the whole way through.
I'm glad I'm here for this part.
Okay. Yeah, I would love to hear what you have to say, because you're kind of a musical person. I mean, we all know Harris is.
Oh, he yes.
comes from a musical family.
Yeah, that's right. I remember from before.
A long memory in the Fabrice.
Yeah.
Brain.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. All right, so here we go. DJ Engineer Doug, what do we have first coming up?
Coming up first is Rune Kincaid's song, Copping a Feel.
Copping a Feel. God, I feel like we have heard this before. But
really?
Let's hear it again. Yeah.
While I'm behind the wheel, I'm looking over at you in the passenger seat, thinking, are those real? Then I gotta stop too fast. Then I gotta break too hard.
Do you think this guy? When do we start making fun of it yet?
No. Yeah, let's hear a little more.
Ooh, copping a feel. Those things are real. At least one of them is. Ooh, copping a feel. It's a simple touch, but it means so much. I could take you out. Get you full of
all right, I think we're about good on that. Well,
I got the gist.
One thing I do want to say is I was watching, you guys couldn't see, but I was watching the video that goes along with it, and this guy's kind of smart because he wrote a song about feeling up girls' boobs, then he shot a video for it, which just consists of him feeling up different big-boobed girls' boobs. So it's kind of genius in a way.
For him to get to do feel up a bunch of...
Yeah, I mean, it's not incredibly funny.
Is
but
he handsome?
I don't know. Engineer Doug, you're more of an authority on this. What would you say?
Yeah, he's totally handsome.
Yeah? Oh, rock right. solid?
Oh, yeah, rock solid.
Yeah, yeah. Slamming?
That makes me like it less.
I would say he's an ordinary looking guy. And no offense to you. What was his name again?
It's Rune Kincaid.
Rune Kincaid. No offense to you, but I think, you know, he has that kind of like Americana, ordinary fellow. Like he's not in a non-threatening way, but mm-hmm. good looking mm-hmm. enough to obviously one of these girls is probably his girlfriend. And
you think he's ever listened to a Flight of the Conchords song?
No, definitely not.
No.
I think he might have.
The chords are so dissimilar, I would say.
Right.
Like, there's no influence
now
at all.
I feel like he did it just so he could like feel some tits. And
so
I hate,
what's wrong with that?
Well, I hate when I know when I'm watching something like TV or something and actors are making out and I know that the guy like likes it. Like mm-hmm. and he doesn't get to do it that often.
Well, you know, that's
in real life.
That's how Kulop and I met.
Is that for real?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She wrote something so she can make out with you?
Yeah, exactly. It was all about Scott Aukerman. I want to put my mouth upon your penis. It was a song she wrote. And we filmed a video for it, and you can see that on at earwolf.com.
Or YouPorn or YouJizz.
Yeah, sure. Either of those.
Yeah.
That's how earwolf.com started, is an offshoot of YouPorn and YouJizz.
I thought it was on a cached version of Super Deluxe.
So, guys, what do you give that? Do you give it mustard or pants? Let's start with Harris Wittels.
I was going to say mustard, but I'll say pants.
You're going to say pants? All right. And Fabrice, what do you
say? Dijon mustard.
Dijon mustard. Wow. Okay. Ooh. So we got one mustard and one Dijon mustard. Okay. Great. All right. What do we have next, DJ Engineer Doug?
We have Chester Shinoda with the Fishhead song.
Oh, the Fishhead song. Now, there is a song called Fishheads by Barnes & Barnes. Mm-hmm. Maybe this is an update version or...
Or maybe their song.
It could be their song.
Chester Shinoda. That's an Americanized Japanese person.
Fusion.
I would say he's half Asian, if I had to guess.
Half Asian. All right, here we go.
Fish heads, roly-poly fish heads, fish heads, fish heads.
So far, I've heard this before.
So far, sounds exactly like this Barnes & Barnes.
Fish heads, roly-poly fish heads, fish heads, fish heads, eat them up, yum.
In the morning, laughing happy fish heads. In the evening, floating in the soup.
Fish heads, roly-poly fish heads, fish heads.
Okay,
fish
let's
heads,
stop this. This is just Barnes & Barnes. He posted Barnes & Barnes.
I like
fish
it.
Heads. It's actually
pants,
great.
Pants.
I give it a pants. What do you give it, Fabrice?
I give that a pants. I give it a nice a Cavaricci pants.
Those are nice.
Enjoyed that. I believe we played it on the show before. That's how much we like it.
Yep.
All right. Good stuff. Thanks so much for sending that one in.
Idiot. Fucking idiot.
All right, DJ Engineer Doug, what do we have next?
Coming up next is Pat Godwin with First Date.
First Date by Pat Godwin.
Fishheads is still playing.
This is perhaps a total original by Pat Godwin. We are about to hear First Date by Pat Godwin here on Comedy Death Ray Radio. Here we go. Love the intro.
Short. Girl, the food was great. The company even better. Why sit here all night long, going on about the weather? I know it's our first date, and good girls gotta wait. But I just turned 83, and you said you're 78. The moon is full, you know what I'm thinking. Let's make love, we're old and we're shrinking. The hour's late, let's just do it on our first date. Unhook your girdle and take off
right.
your face.
Nope, you don't get to stop. We need two votes to stop it.
Chance, it'll be just great.
So we have one from Harris.
On our first date.
Fabrice, dude.
I'm some Viagra.
Oh, God.
Go put your teeth in a jar by the bed.
Come on, Viagra.
Come
on, Viagra.
Smoking out, waking from the dead. I want you right now, so don't give me no lip. It's too late for your hymen, but I might break your hip. The hour is late,
that's
let's
not bad.
Do it on our first day.
All right, okay, I'll
okay,
stop
so
it.
Fabrice is going to stop at this point.
Can
not
I say,
because I didn't like it.
Just you're feeling peer pressure from Harris?
Yeah.
Can all right, Harris, you're obviously dying here. You wanted it stopped. Give us an impression.
Well, I think I know why the guy's name is Pat Godwin, because I kept thinking, God, when is this going to be over?
Now, you are a professional writer for Parks
and Rec.
Wait,
what about Pat? Where was Pat in that?
Don't have to use the whole thing. We aren't Native Americans, right?
How now, brown cow?
Okay.
So you did not like that.
That's from Charles
I had hopes.
In
I thought
Charge.
That, I thought that the, like, the...
What's wrong with it?
I thought that, like, the vocals were okay. I think that it was just a little, like, I don't know, hacky or something. I don't...
Well, okay, let's break it down a little bit further. Now, first of all, the intro, nice,
good,
short.
Good, crisp.
Gets yes. right into it, which
yeah.
a lot
good.
Of these songs...
I will say
it sounds great.
Good. Yeah.
A lot of times people will send in songs and you can't even hear what the lyrics are. These lyrics were very crisp. The production was great. It might have been... I don't know if like he could actually have produced it that well. It sounded like a karaoke track, maybe. I mean, it sounded that good. DJ, what do you think?
He may have been able to do it like a keyboard mm-hmm. program.
It sounded keyboardy.
Sounded great. I kudos to him on the production. So and a clear,
clear idea for the joke.
Yeah, Fabrice.
If that joke were an email, Harris's mother would have forwarded it to him.
mm-hmm. That's how I feel in my heart of hearts. Thank you for, yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
I enjoyed it. I'm going to give that one pants. Harris, what do you give it?
I got to go mustard. I also forced myself to not like it.
So you gave it mustard. You liked it.
No, pants. Yes. Pants. I didn't.
Wait, no, I liked it, so I give it pants. But you give it mustard, so you liked it?
Well, yeah, I guess. So it changes for
every
person.
Yeah, of course.
Right. Well, I guess I go the thing that... Can I say that I forced myself to not like it so that I could say that Godwin joke?
Okay, yeah, let's be honest here.
But honestly,
loved it.
Okay, and Fabrice, what do you give it?
I'm going to give it mustard-colored pants.
Oh, wow, a new category here. Do we have one more, or is that it?
Yeah, we have another one.
All right, let's hear one more. This is our final jukebox jury. This has been going well, though. I've been enjoying this one. It's not the graveyard of human despair that it usually
well,
is.
Well, one person just submitted an existing
I know,
song.
I enjoyed that.
That was fucking...
All right, what do we have?
Oh, we have Eli Braden. Oh,
okay,
with...
we've played his music on the show before.
But he's good. I'd rather play someone that there's a chance that we... would
yeah.
hate or like.
Well,
Eli's
good. A
good
guy.
Yeah.
We've played his music before, but let's be
and
honest
he's
with
great
him.
On Twitter, too.
Yeah, so let's be honest, though, with him. Okay, if we don't like it, we got to make sure we call him out, because he put himself out there. Let's not just let the fact that we know we've met him.
Okay.
I wouldn't say we know him, necessarily, but we met him.
We kind of know him.
Okay.
And I'd feel weird shitting on someone.
I did his Twitter account's crash services.
What? That you can't. Come on. Come on. You can't do that.
All right, so let's hear. What is this song called?
This is Fat Girls.
Fat Girls. I believe I've heard this before, but let's...
Whatever,
let's,
Howard.
Let's judge it honestly.
And to me, if I rule the world, force-feed Stouffer's mac and cheese to every girl. Thin chicks do nothing for me. I like fat girls.
Fat girls.
All these women on TV, skinny as a rail. Girl who can do some damage to a scale. I like my lady friends enormous. I like fat girls.
Jack's frat girls leave dents in the sofa where they sack girls. A woman with a big old butt and spilling out the front of her jeans a nice gut. I like a girl with an appetite. Give her two large pizzas, she can go all night. Grab her boobs in a pillow fight. And if she breaks the bed, well, baby, that's all right.
I'm going to say stop, but it takes two of... No,
I'll
it takes two
we
of
can,
us.
I'll
say. Okay, you'll say... Okay.
Start with you or Fabrice. I got to collect my thoughts.
Please. Do you need a moment? Do you need to pause the tape?
Him. Yeah. I don't know this
person. I come
person.
Back next week.
Yeah, please.
I don't know this person.
So what do you give it? What do you
my
think?
Feelings on it are very complicated.
Okay.
Because on one level, he has done a very admirable job of expressing his care for fat girls.
Sure.
But I think he underestimates the power of diabetes.
I think that Eli, that was a great, well-produced song. Maybe not as crisp and clear as the last one, but I think that maybe the production style, he doesn't want to go with that. DJ Doug, what do you think of it? It's kind of a rap, which is in your sort
wheelhouse.
Of medium.
Me or you?
Me.
I enjoyed it.
You enjoyed it?
Yeah, I think he's got a really good rap style. I didn't, by his picture, I didn't really think that he'd
yeah,
be that
like
good.
Yeah, he's like kind of a white dude.
Very unsuspecting.
Not even kind of one. He is one. I would say it maybe falls within the kind of like, you see a lot of this in comedy songs of the, I like blank, and it's something that a lot of people don't like, and then it's just an excuse for, like a lot of girls don't like fat girls, so I'm going to write a song called I Like Fat Girls and then slam them.
Right.
And, you
know. We call it opposite humor.
Oh, I've never heard that term
like
before.
I like big butts.
Right, because a lot of people hate them.
No, that's just a non sequitur.
Okay.
Oh, were you paying attention?
What are we talking about?
Harris, what do you got?
I was just quoting my memoir from Siegfried and Roy.
I like tiny assholes.
You served large portions?
They fired me when they found out that I liked Big Boss.
All right, what do you got, Harris?
I thought it all sounded good, and it was funny enough. I can't help but think it was a veiled attack on fat girls.
Yeah, so that's what it seems like to you, is like he's saying, I don't like fat girls, and he's making fun of them.
Maybe, a little bit. Well, I could be wrong. I don't know his intentions there.
I don't know. Well, you might say that Weird Al,
If I didn't know him, because I don't know him, but I just know of him from Twitter.
Sure.
He's, you know, funny. He seems like a nice person. So maybe if it was just a complete stranger, I'd be like, oh, that guy's making fun of fat girls.
What if he did a song that was like, I actually like fat girls?
Then I would be sold 100%. Not rhythmically. I think the meter would be fucked.
Maybe, but comedically.
Comedically and just morally, I think I would be more into it.
I actually do like fat girls.
Yeah, I actually do. This isn't a joke. I like fat girls.
Because of their willingness. Right. To please?
Right.
So then, Fabrice, what do you give it, mustard or pants?
I give it 2 chooky-chooky-chookies.
Okay, and Harris, what do you got?
I'll give it pants with a chance of mustard, barring if he puts those changes in.
So pants with a chance.
Pants with a chance.
All right, and I'm going to give it a chance of pants.
Ooh.
Yeah, so yep. DJ Andrew Doug, why don't you weigh in? What do you got?
Mustard.
You give it a mustard. Interesting.
Pants.
So you had mixed
pants.
Feelings about
pants.
It.
Pants. Pants. Scott said chance of pants.
Oh, you wanted a chance.
Pants. Pants.
All right. Well, that was a very successful segment, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, bringing it back. All right. That's how you play Jukebox Jury. And this is the theme to that segment.
I could play that all day. I love that game.
You love it?
Yeah.
Just like Randy Newman loved L.A.
Did he sing about that ever?
I don't think so. That was a well-kept secret.
This song reminds me of the circus where I lost my virginity to Dionne Warwick.
What was she doing there?
Telling the future.
Oh, it's working.
She said, the future is your dick is going to get wet.
How old are you?
I was 9.
And it immediately came true.
Yeah.
Her fortune.
Mm-hmm. She dipped your dick
into her.
Uh-huh. All right, and that is how we play Jukebox Jury.
I don't like when people say they're going to get their dicks wet, but then they have condom sex. You didn't get it. You know what I'm saying?
No, but you put a cup of water inside the condom, and then you put your dick inside of it.
Well, guys, I think that may be it for the show.